All right, so I'm going to show you how I re-encode my Fraps footage so that it could be smaller and better for, upload to YouTube. Because I noticed that Fraps really, they do a decent job of recording the gameplay, but they don't do any compression at all, so it's really a really big file. Like, for instance, these Amnesia files, I recorded them at 30 FPS and only half size, and yet an 8 minute and 49 second video file is 4 gigabytes. So that's a little bit crazy. So, I'm gonna show you how you can, make them not so big without any noticeable quality loss using the free and open source program Vidimux, I believe it's called. So first we're going to open the program. And we're going to load one file into it, just the original Amnesia, first one. And what we're going to do is we're going to go over to this side panel right here under video, change it to MPEG-4 AVC. Then we want to configure it. Change the quality to about, I would say 18. Some people say 20, some people say 22, some people go as high as 26, but I'll say 18 because when you upload it to YouTube, it will also kind of kill your quality a little bit, so we just want to overcompensate for that. And just click OK. And we also want to configure filters because it's a little bit dark, and YouTube adds its own amount of darkness, so we want to make sure people viewing the videos can actually see what they're looking at. So under filters, go to colors and look for Avesync color YUV. Click the little plus button and don't touch anything except level. Change level to PC to TV and click OK. Preview. Close, close. Now look, well, let's look for a second, see how the difference is. This is the original, this is the after. See the difference? That's much clearer. Okay, now under audio, change it to AAC FACC. You don't have to configure it. The bit rate of 128 is pretty much perfect. So that's it. And then all I have to do is change the format to MP4. Save your file. And just let it encode. And now it's done. So let's see what we got here. The original was 4 gigabytes in size. The new one that we just made, 147 megabytes. I think that's a pretty impressive change there, personally. Not bad, huh? All right, so that's how I use it. Hope it's helped. And yeah.